we are encouraging our teachers to take this vaccine because the government is doing it for free. And I said we have around 92,850 teachers in public schools who are 50 years and above. And we have around 16,500 teachers aged 50 and above in private and international schools. And the government has said that these are frontline workers and they will start with those teachers. And I did emphasize that some of the 622 accredited providers for this vaccine, some of them appear in the medical scheme of teachers, and therefore this makes it very easy for teachers to access this vaccine, and therefore we are really saying they should go. I think we are also thanking our teachers and the team, the multi-agency team, all of us from Interior, ICT, the Minister of Education, TSC, and all of us who are involved in this, and for coming up early to start this exam. And thanking the MOSO and the teachers, primary school center managers, for a job well done, and hope that we shall continue with this work and that we shall deliver credible examinations as always. As TSC, we have vetted 227,000 teachers who will be involved in the 2020 national examinations that are underway. The purpose of the vetting was to ensure that only suitable staff were recommended to NEC to participate in the exercise. I therefore urge all the teachers to show high levels of professionalism in executing their mandate as expected. Let's all stick to the NEC regulations given, so that we help our children through this. And I know our teachers are some of the best teachers. Sindio? Yes. So please, I want to be even more proud of you than I have been even in the past. Please let us keep the integrity of these exams. I wish to urge the center managers countrywide to be extra vigilant in guarding the examination papers at our centers against any form of malpractice. As a council member of NEC, I know that we have received reports of planned cheating in more than 20 schools all over the country, which have now been put under closer government surveillance. I'm therefore urging you to ensure that you are provided with the two security officers, and I hope that is what is happening, Bwana DCC and CC, so that we do not have only one security personnel accompanying our teachers. Ensure that you are provided with the two, so that at the center, one of them is stationed at an open place where the unopened examination papers will be stationed. You must not allow your center to hold examinations without the stipulated number of police officers, as we observed when we were going around during the KCP examinations. We shall continue collaborating with the MOH to ensure that gradually all teachers receive the jab. I wish to appeal and encourage examiners who will be traveling to Nairobi after we are through with this exercise for marking to ensure that they are vaccinated before traveling to the city and the environs. As you might have read or you might have heard from the Ministry of Health, Nairobi and its environs have the highest rate of this pandemic. Please, teachers, as you travel to the examiners who will be traveling to Nairobi, please take this jab. The government has made it free for you. Take it so that then we see you live a longer life. More importantly, let's comply, as we even go on with this, with all COVID-19 mitigation measures provided by the Ministry of Health. Ensure that that is what will be in our schools as we administer the examinations. In conclusion, I once again wish to thank all the teachers for their enormous contribution and sacrifice in preparing the candidates underway under very challenging